Good morning students, welcome to your education online class. Today we will continue the second part of forms of education, and in the last day I have discussed the three different types of education: formal, informal and non-formal. And we have learned that informal system of education is a type of education where the child used to see their ancestors, their parents, their grandparents, and they used to imitate and they used to learn whatever they are doing. When the students used to follow someone else belonging to its society is called informal system. Formal system, we have learned all types of school, college and university education, what they used to provide, they used to do and everything, and the examination system and evaluation system is also there. It is called formal system of education. Finally, non-formal system of education is also somewhat systematic, but it is not too much rigid and strict like formal system of education. Today we are going to discuss in details about informal education. Now see, informal education, from the word itself, informal, which is not so much formal in nature, isn't it? It indicates that only. Now when we all were very young, we used to have an idol of our life, that yes, that person is very good or that lady is very good, I want to be like her, I want to be like him. So that is the idol of life which we try to follow throughout our life, isn't it? Now when we are imitating, when we are seeing someone, those who are very close to our heart, those who are very close to ourselves, the process is called informal learning. In primitive age, in ancient ages, there was no such family concept, and even no concept of education was also there, isn't it? So when the group living started, after realization that yes, group living is very very important for individual. Why? Because when they are alone, suppose in forest area some animals attacking, they cannot fight singly with the animals. Then what is happening? They are again jumping. They started living in a group form, and they have thought that yes, when we are in a group, we can fight with our enemies. Like that, not only about enemies, but also about earning money. That was also very important in ancient period. When you will go through your book or you will go through your PDF, you will understand that group living was the initiation of earning money of individual. When they started living in a group, the works were divided into different parts, and they have decided to work separately, and that's why they started earning separately as well. Some people are making, some people are collecting things, the raw materials they are collecting, some people are going from one place to the other for business purpose. Like this, they have changed the entire concept. And slowly they have, and thus when they started living in a group, they started the concept of family as well. Now after the child is born, they used to see that what their parents are doing. They used to bring fruits and vegetables from the forest, they used to make dresses with the leaves on old dry leaves of the plants, they used to make small hut and houses with the help of leaves. So when they used to follow them, and they also continue the same life, because that time there was no concept of house, buildings, like big malls and everything. The life was confined between three basic need: food, shelter and clothes. So food, shelter and clothes, the basic requirement, they used to get it from the forest, and they used to see whatever they have. And the junior one, the children, they also used to have the same thing as they used to follow their parents. So when a student is following someone, when a student is following his parents, or an educant or a learner is following and learning something, it is called informal system of education. So see, informal system of education, J.P. Nair has observed, because great education is J.P. Nair. His book is also there in graduation level. If you take my subject in graduation level, you will see J.P. Nair's book is also there. Is a great educationist. Incidental education means all that one learns as a contaminant of grouping up, growing up in a society. So contaminant means condition. So incidental education means, when incidental education, why it is called incidental education? Because it is occurring suddenly, isn't it? It is happening suddenly. No one has instructed the child to learn. He is seeing his parents, his grandparents, and doing the same thing. So there is an incidental education means all that one learns as a contaminant of growing up in a society. So these are the conditions of the growing up in society. I am hungry. I have to bring fruit from the village, from the forest. I need a shelter to protect myself. I am making houses with old leaves and hay and etc. What is available in the forest. And I am, nowadays also you will see the child is taking his father's office bag and going to office with wearing his big shoes. Isn't it? It happens in our home also. It has happened. So they are trying to imitate. They are trying to be like father. When a girl is preparing herself for her office, or maybe she is ready to drive when she is sitting in her mother's car, she is driving a car like her mother. All these imitations are called informal training. Now these trainings, why it is incidental? These are not provided formally. So the system is called informal education. So definition of what is informal education, definition will come for 2 marks. If you give the definition properly, it is in your book, it is sufficient. Thank you very much. Next class, we will start with the characteristics of informal education.